some of you peeps come on here. I know it's not the best time to do Facebook Live, but I need to get this info out. What's up, Nita? One second here. I'm going to start telling you something where... second. So, wait for some people to pop on here. So, what just happened today is something where if you're not sure about financing, about where to go, especially if you're a veteran, you need to really listen up here, because this is, we saved this couple thousands of dollars. We showed them how to make $700,000 over the next 20 years, and we walked them through the whole gamut, okay? So I sat down with this couple. They already met with a credit union, right? With a credit, with their interest rate was pretty low, okay? Now, you got to understand, credit unions and banks, they drive them down because they don't pay their people crap. Let's just put it out there, okay? It is what it is. But the service you get what you pay for, okay? Because they did not even take this person to a VA loan. They just said, you should go conventional, because they didn't know any better. So they went conventional. And they were going to pay 10% down. So they were going to pay $22,000 down plus pay PMI. Okay, so keep that in mind. $22,000 down plus pay PMI. Okay, they have $40,000 from when they're going to sell their house. Okay, they've got about $30,000 of debt. Okay, so the credit union was going to say, hey, just go get a conventional loan because we don't know how to do VA loans. We, you know, no, that's a bad loan. This guy had no funding fee. Okay. Perfect VA loan, great credit, great history, great eligibility, okay? So, they proposed to him do 10% down, pay PMI, okay? And then pay a much higher payment. Now, with PMI is not tax deductible. It's gone. It's like paying rent to somebody. As soon as you pay somebody, it's gone. It's forever gone. You can't get it back, okay? So, they came in today. We sat down with them, okay? And what we do is fully analyze the whole picture, okay? And they had about $25,000, $30,000 in debt. They're going to get about $40,000, $45,000 in change from the sale of their house. So what we showed them was to walk them through and say, okay, look, let's look at the full picture. What if you pay off the complete debt over here? Let's do 100% financing, okay, VA, no funding fee, because the eligibility, that's the first thing that we actually pull. Their payment was actually less, okay, so here's the first point, was actually less to go VA 100% financing, then go $10,000 down. I mean 10% down, which was $22,000 down. Okay, and then plus closing costs on top of that. Okay, so they basically would be putting a lot more money down and having a higher payment. So that's the first point. Okay, second point is they didn't even know about the second step about, hey, why don't you hold on to your money and then pay off your debt? Okay. That's going to free up about $1,400 to $1,500 per month. You just gave your raise to yourself over $15,000 like that. Okay? So instead of worrying about this, worrying about that, let's pay off your debt from the sale of the house. That's going to free up about $1,500. You just gave yourself a raise over $15,000. Okay? Second point. Third point that we showed the client is, hey, let's take that money, okay, and let's look at your retirement. Retirement's not where it needs to be right now, okay? Let's really get aggressive about that. But before that point, let's fill up your savings for about 3 to 6 months, emergency fund. So we planned that out for them, okay? So in the next 3 months, 3.5 months after they close, that's going to be filled up. And then the next step is let's attack the retirement, okay? Let's fill it up. So from having a low credit rate from our credit company, credit union, can't even speak today, credit union, they basically were going to pay a lot more down, pay a lot more per month, okay? Now we've got them to where they're saving per month about $150, 100% financing, no funding fee. Now also paying off all their debts, okay? Paying off their debt. Now they have a cash flow positive of $1,500. Now step number three is fill up the emergency fund. Step number four is to attack the retirement. Okay, if they attack that retirement, they will make over the next 20 years at conservative about 6%, about $700,000. Okay, so that they were blown away by it. They're like, oh my gosh, this is a game changer. I said, yeah. I said, absolutely. I said, you're gonna have to look when you deal with a mortgage, peeps. You don't just look at the payment rate, closing cost, and that's it. That is ignorant. If you do that, you're gonna be screwed. Okay, these people would have been screwed. They would have drained $22,000 out, okay, make a higher payment, plus pay closing costs on top of that, okay, and then not pay off any of the debt, okay? So when you sit down and you go over mortgage options, this is what I'm talking about. You're going to have to look at the full picture. Hey, and plus on top of that, they didn't have any disability insurance, any life insurance, and we talked about that. We're going to hook them up as well. It's the full picture because, look, if something happens here, okay, let's say, you know, he or she gets hurt. Now, that's going to be a dent on the income. That's going to affect the mortgage. Now, I know most people don't think about that, okay? Most people in commission, they just want to close the deal, get paid, be done, be gone, okay? You got to look at the full picture. You got to look and say, okay, look, they're putting X amount of dollars down. Let's look at their debt. Let's look at this. What can we do? What's lacking? Do they have life insurance? Do they have retirement? They have this and this and this. And this was a veteran. They were going to pump this veteran into a loan that was so unnecessary and it would have cost him so much. And they would have walked around and said, hey, you know, we got a low rate, but what? You would have been absolutely screwed. So this is what I'm talking about. This whole scenario, please share this, comment below, private message. This whole scenario is what I talk about when we sit down for a mortgage presentation. It is not just about having a low interest rate. Sometimes that's the worst thing you could have done. These people would have been financially screwed with the lowest interest rate. So they walked out of here. We spent about 2 hours with them. They signed all their paperwork. They're moving forward. They walked out of here and they were so thankful, so appreciative. And now they have a blueprint, okay, of the next step. I just gave you four steps that we're doing with these people. This is what we do with every client. We analyze it. We pick apart. And then we say, okay, here's step one, two, and three. And then from that point, they're going to be financially strong. We want to build that box, that wall around them, so if anything happens, they are protected. So hopefully this helps some of you. Obviously, we do a lot of loans for veterans. I get pissed when people are in the industry and they run around with the lowest rate. They drive to the bottom with no value whatsoever. And they drive it and they drive it and they drive it, but they don't give any value whatsoever. They don't give any knowledge whatsoever. And then this, something like this comes up, could really have damaged these people and their future. So hopefully this helps. Let me know if you got any questions. Comment down below. Share it on Instagram. Share it everywhere. Okay? I appreciate it. Talk to you soon.